Thank you. Captain Williams awoke on the vestry floor. He couldn't quite remember what had happened to him. He felt a deep inner glow, but an irritation on the left side of his neck as if he'd been stung. Soon afterwards, he and his wife were suddenly transferred to a small rural living. Currently, there's no vicar at St. Austin Friars, but one is urgently being sought, for the dark forces buried deep in the vault could break loose and get seriously out of hand. In this story, Michael Maloney played the young vicar, Melinda Walker, his wife, Michael Deacon, his actor friend, Geoffrey Whitehead, old Phillips, Clifford Norgate, Rubens, Joe Kendall, the secretary. The vampire fraternity was David March, William Henry Drogo, Margaret Robertson, his daughter, Norman Bird, the bishop, John Moffat, Bethel, the undertaker, and Michael Graham Cox, Sergeant Morse. St. Austin Friars was adapted for radio by Stephen Wyatt from the short story by Robert Weston. The director was Martin Jenkins. My name is Edward D'Souza, your man in black. And my story next week takes you into the world of dreams. Or should I say, ladies and gentlemen, nightmares.
You're listening to horror.
What woman in your business? Sherry, what do you mean?
Remember how we talked about
living? I remember. No, you mean... Mm-hmm. Oh, you sweet one. Maybe it will be a son, eh?
Yes, sir.
And we'll name him Jacques. And when he is old enough, we'll take him to the carnival.
That
is enough candy for today.